Hey, well, boy, howdy, boys and girls, men and women of all ages and walks of life. Welcome once again to the building side of the garage. What do we have here today? And I hope you're having a wonderful and blessed day. That's number 62, I believe, on my loop pedal without drums. Here at Randy's Guitar Shop. Hey, guys, what's going on? So if you watch my channel at all, you know that last week I had a few little issues, medical issues, and they have not been overcome yet. And I'm really not supposed to be out here goofing around, but it's just my nature. And I don't like not doing stuff, not being active. Anyways, guys, that being said, I've got a few things here. And as you remember, I did that video last week on that Burl Ash Telecaster kit that my mom-in-law got for me. The goodness of her heart, but we had to send it back. It had too many flaws, especially for something like that, needed to be stained instead of painted. Anyways, guys, well, this one showed up. let's unbox it, see what it is, see what it looks like. You know, maybe it's a little better than the other one. I don't believe it's the same. I think it's completely different. All right, let's get this out of the way. Okay, hey, check it out. It is a Fesley kit. Fesley. DIY electric kit. Look at that cool thing. Wow. Anyways, guys, I've been reading up a lot and seeing a lot of Fesley stuff on YouTube. And it gets pretty good reviews. I haven't seen a lot about their kits, but I've seen their guitars. So let's open this puppy up without any further ado. See if I can't cut all my fingers off too, along with all my other issues. never cut towards yourself. Hope you guys are having a blessed day. You know that? It's kind of weird not making videos. And I've only really missed one or two, but you know, then I was on vacation. Didn't make any then. So this is the really one of the first ones I've made in a while. Well, you guys ready? Holy mackerel, look at this book. That's pretty cool. You usually don't get stuff like that. A lot of them are on the internet or very brief little books. Of course, it's got a whole bunch of advertising. And what it has, basically, my friends, is three different types of guitars. I believe they sell more. There's a Les Paul. Let's see what else they got. This looks like a Telecaster, which is what I think this is. And then, of course, a Stratocaster. That's pretty cool that they kind of cover all three. And then, of course, like at the end, they put all their all the other products they sell. That is pretty cool. Okay, that's a plus one for Fesley over most of the guitar kits. What should we look at first? Let's take out the neck. Necks are pretty dang important, I would say. Leave that out in case we need it again. All right. Now, I don't know what this claims to have. I don't know if this is one of the ones that have the rounded edge stainless steel frets or anything like that. Because, you know, a lot of them say a lot of stuff and then guys review them and go, well, I'm not sure if that's what they really are, but they're good. But, you know, let's just check this thing out. Well, that looks pretty nice. Oh, wow. So it's got a pretty much a Telecaster style. You know, Telecaster is a little different right up in here, but I kind of like this small block. It looks like a bone nut. It does not look like plastic. I don't know that it's cut low enough, really. I don't think it is. But anyways, that being aside, Let's take a quick look at it. There's the ends, if you can see them, if I'm getting that right. This is a very nice chunk of wood. It's obviously, you know, good old maple. We'll just be taking that little festly thing right on off of there, won't we? Well, let's get the old, I just use a paper towel. Some guys use a rag, or like Philip McKnight, he uses a nylon stocking. But as you saw in that last video, remember how those frets absolutely just tore that paper towel up? Let's see what happens. See if I can get you to hear it. Wow. Those are not stainless steel, but I'll tell you what. Coming from overseas, climate change, not climate change. Changes in atmospheric pressure. But changes, you know, like hot and cold and heating up. These things are smooth as silk. And I don't know, shall we look? I don't know if I can get this correctly. I don't know what the angle is, but they look pretty good. If we look down this neck, it looks quite straight. Wow. That is really nice, you guys. So, point number two, A plus. So the book, number one, got an A. Because it's very, very concise. Boy, I just can't get over that. It's got a satin finish. It has a finish on it. So let's put this, let's just put it back where it kind of lives. Wow, pretty cool so far, huh? Let's take this big box out. Boy, it's a telly, all right, guys. Holy mackerel, folks. My goodness. It's got some pieces of wood in it. Let's see here. That's kind of weird, but that's okay. It's just like glue. There's one. Boy, I'm not sure, guys. This is probably three pieces. I don't think it's more than three. I'm not concerned about that at all. Nobody sees that area. But this could be stained. It looks really nice. It's too bad it has that channel there, because if you wanted to run it without a pick guard for whatever reason, you could have, but with that there, you're gonna have to put one on it. It's even got some of those little things. Don't eat these, kids. Wow, and this is, I believe, mahogany. It's not super heavy. Yeah, I think right here, the middle is one piece, and then this. So I think it's a three-piece body. Hey, let's see if the neck fits in there. That's always a something that needs to be done. Wow, that is a beautiful fit. It's not too tight. It can move. I mean, I can't pick it up by the neck. Wow, that is a nice, super tight fit. Of course, we'll do my little cutaway on it. You know, my little thing that I do here. So I still got some of those plates left. What do you think, guys? You know, I never have been a telly guy. I've got a couple, but I've never really been a super telly guy. And the ones that I did own years ago, I cut them all to pieces and completely. See, I did one and I just went like this. What a bad idea that was, but I did it. I put a whole bunch of weird electronics in it, and in those days, I wanted the Strat sound, and I'd never really had a Strat, and I really wanted that Strat sound. So I thought by putting these two pickups in, hey, a quick side note, or a quick thing. So when I bought the pickups for that guitar way back in the very early 80s, I bought them from what's called Musician Supply, out of San Diego. Well, that turned into Musician's Friend years later. The same owners, but they kind of didn't make it with Musician Supply. Anyways, I bought these little pickups called Shadow pickups. And they were pretty nice, you know. but I didn't know anything about any of that stuff in those days. And I had like four miniature switches and a three-way switch. No matter what I did, it never, ever sounded like a Strat. It sounded like anything but a Strat. So I kind of learned a lesson. I don't know. Let's put this back in its little house. Well, that looks really nice, you guys, doesn't it? And they branded it just about everywhere. So that is A1, A+. That looks great. And like I said, that neck looks really nice too. Let's take this out. Got your bag of parts. Typical little old pick guard for a Telecaster with a pickup. Definitely a ceramic pickup. Look at the magnet on that thing. A decent looking bridge. It is not a string through. But look at that, guys. It has the holes drilled for that. So if you wanted to use this bridge, you can either top load it or you could do string throughs. Now that's pretty cool. So if I got the nerve to go string through, because let's take another look at that. I'm sure there's no string holes on the back. Nope. So I'd have to do that myself. And I'll tell you, I have done that. I was gonna say I've attempted it twice, but I've done it twice and both times the holes were off. They worked. But, you know, if you were looking at it seriously, they were off. Hope this isn't boring you guys to death. Yeah, another great big huge ceramic magnet on there. And this is a pretty funky plate, but that's really neat that you've got that option here. And you know what else I like about it? Is a whole lot of Telecasters kits do not have these front holes. So you're basically being held down by three or four screws right here and nowhere else. I've always thought that was weird. And a couple of the really fancy plates, like on my Burl Ash Tele, I drilled my own holes in there and put it in there because it was looking like, kind of like it was pulling up. You know, the more pressure you put on it back here, the more it's gonna pull up in the front. So anyways, guys, that's pretty much it. Let's take a look at the controls. Typical, very inexpensive, cheap little controls. Don't know if we'll change that or not. You can tell I haven't done a video in a while. I'm all discombobulated. All right, let's look at this puppy. It's just so typical. It's got the little itty bitty green guy. Oh, it's a plug and play. That's kind of cool. Super cheap, but you know, not the worst ever I've seen. This feels much better than a lot of the Tele switches I've seen. I've got one over there. And as you can see, if you look at it right here, I mean, it really sounds good. The other one I've got that's on a control plate, it's just, you can always see all this cheap plastic. And this almost looks like it's metal. It's probably not, but it looks like it. So at least they tried to disguise it. Yeah, the big thing, putting it in upside down. That's a big thing these days. But then you have to change those two. You have to put the volume up here. But I know guys that won't play them unless they're that way. I can't say as to if that's better or not. And of course, it's got all your other cheapo stuff, your cheap strings, your cheap guitar cable. You know, just for the fun of it, let's look at that guitar cable. You know, it might be the best one I've ever had. Actually, the best one I ever had, my friend Dave gave to me. Yeah, this is a typical, at least it's got a right hand on there. The hardware looks, typical El Cheapo. And you know, we won't use any of that. You know, I must have 10 sets of unused brand new tuning pegs, tuning keys, because I like locking tuners and I just won't use anything else. So hey guys, typical plate, which I will not use. You know, and this is a 3-barrel, so if I was to use this, it's not an option, I mean, you know, staggered. So I would probably put some nice brass barrels on there. But I just don't know if I'll use this bridge. But I could. Anyways, guys, that is pretty cool. This is a, I believe it, under $100, maybe quite a bit US. That's a quality, that's good quality for $100. Let's put it that way. You know, I just put that away without putting this back in there. Well, there it is, guys. Let's take one more quick look at it. Let's put it together. Wow. So if you guys are looking to build a kit, I can honestly say, at least from my perspective and point of view, for the very first part of this build, this is very high quality for what I paid. This is as good as... it's as good as the solo kit I got from Canada, which was a couple $100 way back before kits were really popular, right at the beginning of COVID when they started selling a lot of kits. And that was all mahogany and it was very, very good. It's the best quality kit I ever got was that solo kit. This compares to that. In fact, fretwork and neck wise, it's even better. I love the feel of this neck. It's just great. Okay, guys. Can you see it? Am I gonna be a rock star or a country picker? Neither one. Anyways, guys, I hope you enjoyed that video. I will say that at least for my part, for right now, I can endorse this Fesley kit. Like I said, I think they only have like 3 or 4 different kits. And that's about it. I think they have a Strat, a Tele, and probably a Les Paul. But from just looking at this thing to start out with, very high quality, and it's full thickness. Anyways, guys, I love y'all for watching the videos. I hope you made it through this one. If not, I'm sorry. please like and subscribe if you haven't already. I have a few more subscribers. Thank you very much. Share the videos. Give me a thumbs up. I don't know what's going to happen last weekend, not next weekend. Last weekend, I promised I was going to come out and make a video. I couldn't. I was on my back. I could not come out here. In fact, I'm not supposed to be out here right now, so don't tell my doctor. Anyways, guys, once again, have a wonderful and a blessed week. Don't forget to pray for your country, whatever country it is. And if you do live in the United States, please get out and vote. And I hope you vote for the right person. This country is in all kinds of problems and turmoil. If we get the wrong people in office, this country could take a nosedive like you've never seen before. Anyways, guys, that being said, pray for the world. This world is an upheaval, especially over in Israel and all those places. There is just all kinds of problems. Everybody wants everybody else's stuff. People want to eliminate other people, for God's sakes. What's up with that? You know, I might have a difference with you, but I don't want to eliminate you. Anyways, guys, don't forget to pray for your friends, neighbors, and loved ones that need medical attention. Heck, you could even pray for old Guitar Zan if you wanted to. You know, I've got this little issue and it's not going away quick. So anyways, guys, that being said, if I don't get caught and busted by my wife, maybe I'll be out here this weekend doing a demonstration or a look at something, you know. Anyways, guys, once again, don't forget to pray for your friends, neighbors, and loved ones that need medical attention. They're out there. Thankfully, one that's been very, very important to us, really a very serious, crucial thing. I'm just not going to go into that, but so far that has made a huge turnaround. We're talking positive. So I'm not going to sit here and tell you I know the answer to that, but I do know that a lot of prayers went out. So, and obviously at this point, I believe they're helping. Anyways, guys, I will see you later. I don't know when. Bye-bye.